Hello friends, welcome to the expert lecture series of Technocrats Group of Institutions, Bhopal. I am Dr. Archana Sharma, Associate Professor in Electronics and Communication Department, TIT Group of Institutions, Bhopal. Today I am going to deliver lecture on the topic Directed Resonator Antenna for Microwave and Millimeter Wave Applications. I have chosen this topic because this is one of the latest research area in the field of microwave and millimeter wave applications. The contents I am going to cover in this presentation includes introduction of directed resonator, directed resonator application. Next, we will discuss directed resonator as an antenna and advantages of DRA. Then we will cover review on bandwidth enhancement methods. This will be followed by design aspects of rectangular DRA, in which we will discuss the mathematical modeling of DRA, that is directed waveguide model, coupling theory and different mathematical design equations. I will also show you some of the DRA models and simulation results, which is very important to understand the practical relevance of the DRA in microwave applications. Finally, we will talk about performance summary and concluding remarks. Before starting with the introduction of dielectric resonator, let me draw your attention towards the need of dielectric resonator antenna. DRA is a next generation low loss antenna for wireless applications because of the following reasons. As the lower microwave band is very much crowded, it is required to shift to higher microwave and millimeter wave frequency operations. Antenna systems and components need to be modified accordingly. Also, to support high data rate applications and to accommodate increasing number of users, wideband antenna system need to be designed. Although microstrip antenna has many advantages and is widely used at microwave bands, but when it is used for higher microwave and millimeter wave band, its performance is degraded because of increased conductor losses. As we all know that the attenuation in metal antenna is directly proportional to the frequency of operation. So, higher the frequency of operation, more will be the conductor loss. Thus, the availability of low loss temperature stable microwave dielectric materials draw the attention of researchers to develop wideband directed resonator antenna for microwave and millimeter wave band. Now, let me give you the introduction of directed resonator. In 1939, R.D. Richmyer showed that the non-metallic objects can also resonate for narrow range of frequencies, which he called directed resonators. A dielectric resonator is an electronic component that exhibits resonance for narrow range of frequencies, especially in the microwave and millimeter wave band. Dielectric resonator generally consists of a puck of ceramic that has a low dissipation factor. Figure shows the different shapes of dielectric resonators. Now, we will talk about dielectric resonator applications. Dielectric resonators have been widely used in shielded microwave circuits such as cavity resonators, filters and oscillators. Dielectric resonator kept inside the metal cavity offers high Q factor and act as their dielectric resonator filter. Dielectric resonator, when used at input or output stage of the tuned circuit inside the metallic cavity, work as dielectric resonator oscillator. Dielectric resonator oscillator offers high FM voice performance and frequency stability over conventional resonators and used for the high frequency generation. In recent years, dielectric resonators are also used as an antenna in microwave and millimeter wave band. Figure 2A and 2B show the practical view of dielectric resonator filter and dielectric resonator oscillator respectively. Now let us discuss what is dielectric resonator antenna. Dielectric resonator kept in an open environment with proper excitation act as an antenna and hence named as dielectric resonator antenna. Dielectric resonator antennas are fabricated from low loss temperature stable microwave dielectric materials. Resonant frequency of DRA is a function of shape, size and dielectric constant of dielectric resonator. Now, how VRA works. Radio waves are introduced into the inside of the directed resonating material from the transmitter circuit and bounce back and forth between the resonator walls, forming standing waves. The walls of the resonator are partially transparent to radio waves, allowing the radio power to radiate into space. Now, let us discuss the advantages of directed resonator antenna. Dielectric resonator antenna can be easily integrated with MMIC, that is microwave and millimeter wave integrated circuits, due to its small size and low volume. DRA is made up of low loss microwave dielectric materials and has very low dielectric loss. DRA has no conductor and surface wave losses as there is no conductor material. It also does not have frequency drift with temperature variation, as made up of temperature stable microwave dielectric materials. It is easily excited with the existing field methods such as probe field, microstrip field, slot field, etc. It is a volumetric source and has larger effective aperture. Thus, it also offers high radiation power factor and high radiation efficiency. These are the different bandwidth enhancement methods. Many researchers have given their contribution towards the enhancement of bandwidth of DRA. Some of the important methods are discussed here, such as introducing air gap method, parasitic DRA method, cavity gap DRA method, stacking DRA, dual resonance DRA, higher order mode DRA. Now, this is a simple directed resonator antenna geometry which was proposed in 1983 by S.A. Long. In this antenna design, metal antenna is directly replaced by dielectric resonator, which is made up of TiO2, which is having a dielectric constant 50. So it has low loss tangent and high Q factor. This antenna is easy to design and it acts like a low loss antenna. The demerit of this antenna design is its narrow bandwidth, which is typically 5% only. So this is a very simple bandwidth enhancement method, that is the air gap method, which was proposed in 1994. In this method, air gap is introduced between ground plane and the dielectric resonator, and the bandwidth can be enhanced by varying the height of the air gap. The Q factor can be effectively reduced, that exhibits a broader bandwidth. Operating bandwidth range of this design is obtained to about 30 to 17%. The demerit of this design is again the large volume and it requires extra support. This design is less reliable and cannot be used in hazardous environmental condition. Now this is another method for bandwidth enhancement, which is parasitic DRA. It was proposed in 1998. In this, it is shown in the figure that the dielectric resonator, which is directly fed with microstrip feed line, is termed as active DRA, whereas the elements which are electromagnetically coupled, are termed as parasitic DRA. Parasitic elements produces a wide band operations. In this design, the individual dielectric resonator bandwidth is about 5.8%, whereas the combined effect of parasitic elements gives the wide band operation. And this bandwidth is obtained to about 17%. This design also gives the improved gain. The demerit of this design is a single feed network, as we can see in the figure. It has no matching network. Again, the low coupling to the parasitic element is also one of the major drawbacks. This structure is complex in nature and its volume is also increased to increase the bandwidth of the DRA. Now, another method is a multi-segment DRA, which was proposed in 2000. In this method, the problem of low coupling to parasitic DRA is overcome by stacking the one directed resonator element onto another. In this design, we can see that the low high dielectric constant directed resonator is placed below the low dielectric constant directed resonator. In this, the coupling is improved due to high dielectric constant dielectric resonator, whereas the bandwidth operation is obtained due to low dielectric constant material. The bandwidth achieved in this design is around 20%. Again, here the bandwidth is improved at the cost of volume and complexity. Next method is cavity-backed DRA, which was also proposed in 2000. As we can see in the figure that the metal cavity is placed on the back of the DRA, which removes the undesired radiation. It also improves the front-to-back ratio and gain. The bandwidth achieved is 20%. The demerit of this design is that it increases the volume and weight of the design. Frequency temperature variation is also observed due to metal cavity, and spurious modes due to metal cavity are also the main drawback of this cavity back DRA method. Next method is dual resonance method, which was proposed in 2005. This method is very important as it improves the gain, it improves the bandwidth of the DRA without increasing the overall antenna size. In this method, resonances of slot and DRA are combined together to improve the bandwidth. The main thing, the main concept used in this DRA is that the resonant, slot feed is a resonant structure. So here bandwidth is obtained to about 25%. Preservation of the radiation pattern and polarization of the entire bandwidth is also maintained, because slot as well as dielectric resonator are the short magnetic dipole. It offers compact and small size antenna design. The demerit, we can say that the bandwidth improvement is required further to make it useful for wideband applications. This is the method which was recently proposed in 2011. In this method, the dual band operation is obtained due to higher order mode. The bandwidth in lower band is 15%, which is obtained due to TE111 mode, and in the upper band, bandwidth is obtained to about 8.3%, which is due to the next higher order mode, that is TE113 mode. The operating bands that was covered in this design are WiMAX and WLAN. The demerit of this antenna design is that it is using a larger ground plane of 11 into 11 centimeters square, and the bandwidth improvement is required further to make it useful for wideband applications. So here we have, we can see the comparative analysis of bandwidth enhancement methods. Here we can see the simple DRA can only give the bandwidth of about 5%. Introducing air gap between ground plane and DRA offer the bandwidth between 30 to 70%, whereas this is not reliable and cannot be used for hazardous environmental conditions. Parasitic DRA offers the bandwidth of about 17%. Multi-segment DRA offers the bandwidth of about 20%. Cavity backed DRA offers the bandwidth of about 18%. In dual resonance method, bandwidth achieved is around 25%. In dual resonance, in higher order mode method, the dual band operation is obtained. The lower band bandwidth is 15%, whereas the upper band bandwidth is 8.3%. So we can conclude that the dual resonance method is very effective to enhance the bandwidth without increasing the overall size of the antenna. Also, to obtain the dual band operation, we can utilize the higher order modes of the dielectric resonator antenna. Now let us discuss the design aspects for DRA. Dielectric resonator antenna performance depends on the following parameters: shape of the DRA, dimensional parameter of the DRA, permittivity, dielectric constant of DR material and substrate, excitation or coupling method. There are various possible shapes of DRA, in which the most popular shapes are rectangular DRA, cylindrical DRA, ring DRA. Rectangular DRA is most widely used because of its high design flexibility. It also has the advantage of low cross polarization effect. Cylindrical DRA is simply useful for obtaining the circular polarization, but it suffers from the problem of degenerate modes. Ring DRA is a variation of cylindrical DRA, in which a concentric cylindrical cylinder is cut from the cylindrical layer, which eliminates the problem of more degeneracy in the cylindrical DRA. Now, let us discuss the directed waveguide model for rectangular DRA. Directed model represented in the figure is considered to estimate the initial values of directed resonator dimensions. According to directed waveguide model, directed resonator is considered to be placed on infinite ground plane, and any theory is used that replaces the ground plane directed resonator with isolated DR of height of 2h, as we can see in the figure 32. It is assumed that the image DRA surfaces are perfect magnetic conductors at x equal to plus minus L by 2 and z equal to plus minus h. Since image theory is used, permanent electric conductor, that is PEC wall, is not considered at z equal to 0. Figure 13 is representing the field configuration corresponding to the modes TE111, TE112, TE113. The direction of wave propagation here is y direction. In case of mode TE112, as shown in the figure, field is supposed to exist at z equal to 0, which is a perfect electric conductor, and hence it does not satisfy the boundary condition of radiation model. Thus, TE111, TE113 mode exist, but TE112 does not exist in rectangular DRA. Here are the resonant frequency equations. FR1 is equal to C upon 2 pi under root of epsilon R multiplied by under root of kx square plus ky square plus kz square. FR1 and R2 is the two resonant frequency in mode TE111 and TE113 respectively. Ky is equal to under root of k square minus kx square minus kz square. 1 and 2 is the two resonant frequency in the lower and upper band for mode TE111 and TE113. K naught square epsilon r is equal to kx square plus ky square plus kz square. Kx1 equal to kx2 equal to pi upon L. Kz1 equal to pi upon 2h and Kz2 equal to 3 pi upon 2h for the velvet antenna design. For the velvet designing, frequency selection criteria for TE11M and TE11N is F2 upon F1 should be less than under root of N square plus M square plus 1, where N is greater than M. Here K1 and K2 are wave numbers in dielectric, and K0 is free space wave number, that is 2 pi F0 upon C. F0 is a frequency in free space. K1 is equal to 2 pi under root of epsilon R F1 upon C, and K2 is equal to 2 pi under root of epsilon R into F2 upon C. Kx, Ky and Kz are the wave numbers in x, y and z directions respectively, which can be determined from the boundary conditions, and epsilon r is a dielectric constant of dr. The difference between FR1 and FR2 mainly depends on the Kz1, Kz2 or height of dielectric resonator. Dielectric waveguide model only considered the imaged and isolated DRA, so the dimensions of dielectric resonator antenna may be adjusted accordingly when coupling is applied to DRA. These are the general design formulae which can be used for designing of single band compact antenna design. And size of the dielectric resonator antenna is directly proportional to the lambda naught upon under root of epsilon r. So height of the DRA is equal to lambda naught upon 4 under root of epsilon DRA. LDRA is equal to lambda naught upon under root epsilon DRA. WDRA is equal to lambda naught upon 2 under root of epsilon DRA, where epsilon DRA is a dielectric constant of dielectric. directive resonator material used for the designing of directive resonator antenna. Lambda naught is a free space wavelength. Substrate thickness HS can be calculated by the equation 0.3 C upon 2 pi F under root of epsilon S, where C is the speed of light and epsilon S is the directive constant of the substrate used for antenna designing. HS is the thickness of the substrate. Total height of the directive resonator antenna will be equal to HDRA plus HS, where HDRA is the height of the directive resonator, whereas HS is the thickness of substrate material used in the DRA design. Next, the ester length can be used in the directive resonator antenna to obtain the impedance matching. So, ester length can be calculated as lambda g upon 4, where lambda g is a guide wavelength. Guide wavelength is equal to lambda naught upon under root of epsilon r effective. Slot width WS is equal to 0.2 LS. LS is the slot length, which is equal to 0.4 lambda naught upon epsilon r effective. Effective dielectric, epsilon r effective is the effective dielectric constant, which is equal to HT, that is the total height of the antenna, upon HDRA upon epsilon DRA plus HS upon epsilon S. HDRA is the height of the dielectric resonator, epsilon DRA is the dielectric constant of dielectric resonator, HS is the height of the substrate, and epsilon S is the dielectric constant of the substrate material. The field line dimension can be approximated by maintaining a ratio of 3.96. Now, let us discuss some of the DRA performance parameters. Here it is a resonant frequency. Resonant frequency is a frequency for which DRA offers resonance, that is the maximum output. In the return loss plot, frequency with minimum return loss is referred to as resonant frequency. Return loss is a measure of reflected power and signifies the antenna matching. It is defined as the ratio of reflected power to the incident power. Now, we can define the bandwidth as antenna bandwidth is a width of frequency over which antenna maintains required characteristics. Bandwidth can also be calculated from return loss plot and referred to as return loss bandwidth, for which DRA maintains the return loss below or equal to minus 10 dB. Then the percentage bandwidth can be calculated as FH minus FL upon FC into 100%, FC equal to FH plus FL upon 2, where FH is a higher cutoff frequency, FL is a lower cutoff frequency, FC is a center frequency. The bandwidth can also be related to the radiation Q factor, and it is equal to S minus 1 upon Q radiation minus under root of S, where S is a standing wave ratio and Q radiation is a radiation Q factor. Now, what is Q factor? Q factor is also related to the dielectric losses in the dielectric material. The higher the Q factor, better will be the material. The Q factor is equal to 2 pi into total energy stored by antenna upon energy dissipated or radiated per cycle. Q radiation is equal to 2 omega naught WE upon P radiation, where WE is the total stored energy by the antenna and P radiation is the radiated power. QD is a dissipation quality factor, which is equal to omega naught W upon PD, which is where W is the stored energy by antenna and PD is the dissipated power in the directed resonator antenna. Q dissipation is also equal to 1 upon 10 delta. 10 delta is a loss tangent. Now, what is loss tangent? Loss tangent. Loss tangent of dielectric material is determined by it is equal to sigma upon omega epsilon naught epsilon r, where epsilon naught is a free space dielectric constant and epsilon r is a relative dielectric constant of dielectric resonator. Now, here from the graph it is clear that the resonant frequency is decreasing on increasing the dielectric constant of DRA. Low dielectric constant materials offer higher microwave frequency operation, and high dielectric constant materials are useful at lower microwave band operation. dielectric constant is related to material ability to transmit or permit electric field. So we can conclude here that the low dielectric constant dielectric resonators are useful for higher microwave frequency operation, and we can opt the high dielectric constant dielectric resonator material to design a antenna for lower microwave band operations. Now this is a table in which we can see the analytical relations for DRA. As we can see here that if dielectric constant is increasing, loss tangent of the dielectric resonator will be decreasing, resonant frequency will be decreasing, radiation Q factor is increasing, bandwidth is decreasing, gain is increasing. So these relations has been concluded from the mathematical design equations which we have discussed earlier. Also we can see if we choose the lower dielectric constant or dielectric resonator, this lower dielectric constant will give the higher value of loss tangent, and we know that the loss tangent Q factor is inversely proportional to the loss tangent, so Q factor will be decreased, and Q factor and bandwidth are inversely proportional, so bandwidth will be increased, and if the loss tangent is high, the gain of the antenna will be low. So here we can say that if you want to design a wideband dielectric resonator antenna, we need to choose a lower dielectric constant material, and if we want to design a high gain dielectric resonator antenna, we need to choose a high dielectric constant dielectric resonator material. This is the list of manufacturers which are providing the different dielectric compound materials. Some of the dielectric compound, the dielectric materials are shown having the different dielectric constant values between 11 to 15. Different manufacturers are NTK, Transtech, Temex, Murata, Bell Labs, Immersion Cumin, and so on. So by using this list, we can obtain our desired dielectric constant dielectric resonator for designing our dielectric resonator antenna. Now, coupling theory. So, dielectric waveguide model is only used to analyze the field and resonant frequency for our image DRA. Here, DRA to be useful, energy must be coupled into or out of the element through one or more ports. Electric current source like probe should be located in an area of strong electric fields within the DRA for strong coupling. Magnetic current source like a loop should be located in the area of strong magnetic fields to achieve strong coupling. Field structures of the isolated DRA need to be understood to determine whether the field should be placed to excite the appropriate mode in the DRA. Boundary conditions and coupling theory applied to isolated DRA gives the coupling factor K. K is proportional to the volume integral of E2 dot J1 dB, where E2 is the electric field intensity and J1 is the RF electric current density. K is also proportional to the volume integral of H2 dot M1 dB, where H2 is a magnetic field intensity and M1 is a magnetic current density. Q external is equal to Q upon K. Here are the various coupling methods. The various coupling methods which can be used with DRA are probe coupling, slot coupling, microstrip field coupling, slot waveguide coupling, slot image waveguide coupling, image guide coupling. Out of these coupling methods, the mainly used coupling methods are probe coupling, microstrip field line coupling, and slot coupling, which we will discuss one by one. Here in this figure, we can see that the probe coupling is used by two ways. In the first figure, A, probe is placed adjacent to the DRA, in which the electric field is excited on the DRA due to magnetic field, so it acts like a short magnetic dipole. In the figure B, we can see that the probe is inserted inside the dielectric resonator, so the field is excited in the DRA due to the electric field, and it acts like a vertical electric current source as shown in the figure. Now let us discuss slot coupling. In the slot coupling, a slot is cut on the ground plane and field is placed on the back of the ground plane. DRA is placed on the center of the slot to have the maximum coupling. Here slot is a magnetic dipole and DRA is excited due to the magnetic field, so it acts like a short magnetic dipole. In figure 17b, a microstrip coupling is shown in which DRA is placed on the same side of the microstrip field line and DRA is excited due to the magnetic field line, so it acts like a short magnetic dipole. Now we will compare the aperture slot coupling and probe coupling method, which are most widely used for exciting the directed resonator antennas. Aperture slot coupling acts as a short magnetic dipole. In it, coupling depends on the slot length and the DRA position. It has advantage of having field network below ground plane, which avoids spurious radiation. Microstrip stub cancels out the reactive component of the slot. At L bend or below, the slot size becomes extremely large, so it is useful above L bend. As far as probe coupling is concerned, probe located inside the DRA act as short electric dipole, and probe located adjacent to the DRA act as a short magnetic dipole, as we have seen in the figure. Coupling depends on the probe height and DRA location. It has the advantage of direct coupling to a 50 ohm system. It is used at lower microwave frequencies where aperture coupling may not be practical due to large size of the slot. Directed resonator antenna can be analyzed by using the finite element method. Finite element method is a frequency domain technique which is based on the finite plane. DRAs of arbitrary shape can be solved by FEM, discretization of the symmetry, usually using small tetrahedrons. Entire volume surrounding the DRA must also be discretized, increasing the computational size of the problem. It determines the effect of a finite ground plane on the radiation pattern of a DRA. In this FEM method, more accurate solutions are obtained. Another advantage of FEM is its availability as commercial software, where graphical user interfaces are provided to simplify the geometrical definition of the problem. HFSS, that is High Frequency Structure Simulator, is based on finite element method. Now, let us discuss some of the DRA models which are simulated on HFSS, that is High Frequency Structure Simulator. Here is a low profile DRA which is designed for 5 GHz resonant frequency. The directed resonator is made up of dielectric constant TI, dielectric constant 50, which is the dielectric constant of TiO2. These are the design parameters which are used to design this DRA. Now, this is the simulation results. Students always find it difficult to interpret and understand the simulation results. So here we can see how to interpret this simulation results. In this figure, the return loss of this rectangular DRA is shown. So we can see that the minimum return loss is 22.7 at frequency 5 GHz. So this is the resonant frequency for which we are obtaining a minimum return loss. Here it is a 5 GHz. It offers single band operation. The bandwidth we can calculate by FH minus FL, and percentage bandwidth can be calculated as FH minus FL upon FC into 100%, and FC can be calculated by FH plus FL upon 2. This is a radiation pattern of simple rectangular DRA. Here it is shown in the figure that the maximum the maximum gain in the forward direction is 12.42, and the back flow has a field strength of 1.89. So front to back ratio can be calculated by subtracting these two values, and it is obtained to about 10.6 dB. In the second figure of in the figure 20B, we can see the directivity pattern at 5 GHz frequency, that is resonant frequency. We can see here the maximum directive gain is termed as directivity. So here directivity is 5.64 dBi. So this design, this directive resonator antenna is offering a good front to back ratio and reasonable directivity. This is summary, performance summary table of this simple DRA. This antenna, directive resonator antenna, is useful for IEEE 802.3A/NWN as it covers